A major thing I have felt a lot is like imposter syndrome. It's like, do I really belong here? Am I really doing like, or am I just like a clueless girl just trying to be with cattle? I know I'm not, because I'm always looking to learn more, and I'm not scared to get dirty or get up close. You know, it's not just looking at the cattle and saying it's pretty. You're gonna have to get blood and liquids and fluids on you. And it's like, yeah, that's fine. My name is Alondra Cruz. I was born in Honduras and I come from Honduras. My whole family is from there. I did my master's in Honduras. Being there, directly seeing it face to face is a whole different story. And it makes you realize for many people, it's just like what they're gonna live off of. That's scary. They depend on the food they're producing to feed themselves. And if there's any leftover, then they'll be able to sell it. Seeing the way that they're still able to produce and keep doing it and trying different methods shows their resilience. And that to me was really eye-opening. I'm like, okay, I want to contribute. I am currently a PhD student in the Plant and Soil Science Department at Texas Tech. So my research focuses on integrated forage livestock systems, especially looking at sorghum and permillet as alternative forage options in drought environments or any water limited environment. This is the best place to do my research. Water limited, very high, hot temperatures. I feel like if you're able to prove or show in some way that you have these crops that can be an alternative, then you're really saying, okay, not only can we produce when it's such an extreme, but imagine what it can do in a great environment. If your summer fails right now, it's like, okay, too bad, it sucked, it failed. You have to do it again next summer. So what if this was your last summer and you could have like been a, like this was your last year, then it's like, okay, now you need to stay another year. We have a novel line of sorghum, which is prussic acid free or free of durin, which is the metabolite that's gonna make it toxic or give it that anti-nutritional component. We really wanna see and understand how removing the durin affects the overall productivity of the plant. Smaller farmers, their reality is today is very different from the reality 20, 40 years ago. The environment, higher temperatures, flooding in areas where there wasn't as much flooding before. All of these things are happening, and not only do we need to make policies that are going to help the producers, but also realize how they can adapt or mitigate to these changes themselves. To me, my identity is not like, oh, I'm only from here, I'm only from here. I feel like my background or all the places I come from make me today. You know, this is my home too. I really want to give back to my communities, not only in Honduras, but also in the US, like be able to contribute to the places I love. I want it to actually mean something to somebody.